The first possible mention of Iceland in historical records could have been in the now-lost work On the Ocean by Greek explorer Pytheas in the later 4th century BCE. Thankfully, some incomplete description of his work have survived in later works of Strabo and Polybius. There they mentioned that Pytheas talked about the land called Thule, which was a six-day sail north of Britain, and is near the frozen sea. However, these weren't the only mentions of Thule, and writers like Procopius, Orosius, Pomponius continued to cite Pytheas in their works, however with very differing outcomes. Some clearly talked about Norway when they mentioned Thule, some even said Thule was Ireland or Scotland, and some described Thule's location very close to Iceland's location, but there was never any definitive proof of what Thule was exactly. It seems like when ancient writers were writing about a place that was very far north, they usually just called it Thule, and that's why we are stuck with writings that when talking about Thule could be or are mentioning any of these places, and in most writings we can't even know for sure. Later in the 6th century CE, Saint Brendan could have spotted Iceland and its volcanic activity, as he wrote that he saw an island that threw down lumps of fiery slag. However, the writings of Saint Brendan voyages have a very mythical aspect to them and aren't very reliable. First real mention of Iceland as Thule is most likely by Disuil, an Irish monk and geographer. He states that he has met clerics that claim to live in Thule, which is north of the Faroe Islands, and then continued to explain a little bit more about the island. The statement of Disuil that there are Irish monks living in Iceland during the 8th and 9th century is supported by the archaeological finds in Hafnir, where carbon dating tells us that Iceland was in fact populated during the 8th and 9th century. It is more supported by the fact that Thorgilsson writes that small bells corresponding to those used by Irish monks were found by the Norse settlers. Now, whether the monks left before the Norse arrival in Iceland or were driven out by the Norse settlers is unknown. The first Norse discovery of Iceland, according to Landnámabók, the Book of Settlements, was a Norwegian named Nadadur, who lost his way at sea and found Iceland, which he named Snowland. After Nadadur, there were a couple more Norse explorers that came to Iceland, like Garor Svavarsson and later Raven Floki, who named the island Iceland. The story goes that the Raven Floki failed to prepare accordingly to the Icelandic winter, and so his animals died as a result. In the spring, him and his settlers decided to leave, but before he left, he hiked to the top of the nearby mountain and noticed a large fjord full of sheets of ice. A frustrated Raven Floki therefore gave it a cold and unsympathetic name, Iceland. The first permanent Norse settler, according to the Book of Settlements, was a Norwegian chieftain Ingolfur Arnarson, the son of Nor and his blood brother Leifur, later to be known as Hjorleifur. The most common reason given as to why they decided to move to Iceland is that they were warriors that have become involved in a slaying, and moving away to Iceland seemed like a sensible choice. So in the year 1870, or maybe 1874, but definitely by the year 1877, Ingolfur managed to set up a permanent residence in Iceland. According to the stories, Ingolfur casted his high seat pillars and vowed to set farm wherever they washed ashore. This happened to be in a bay which he named Reykjavik, loosely translating to Smoky Bay, possibly due to the steam from hot springs nearby. Later, Ingolfur's brother and his party was killed by their Celtic slaves, but Ingolfur managed to avenge them and continue living in Iceland. Now, the written records of the Book of Settlements and the Book of Icelanders aren't the best reliable sources for knowing what exactly happened during the Norse settlement of Iceland. Many scholars debate the high seat pillar story, and even if Hjorleifur, the blood brother of Ingolfur, was real. Same goes for the stories of Raven Floki and Garor Svavarsson. Also, the fact that the sources were written around the 11th and 12th century, almost 200 to 400 years after the supposed settlement of Iceland, doesn't help the reliability. Now, thanks to ice sheet dating and carbon dating, we know for sure that there was a human settlement around Reykjavik in 871, which would support the written records. However, there are some archaeologists that say their excavations in Vestmann Islands date the settlement of Iceland decades, if not centuries, earlier than 871. For now, we don't know for sure exactly when and how Iceland was settled, but we do know for sure that by the late 9th century, we can find swords and pagan graves of Norse settlers, which is supported by the Book of Settlements, indication of large movements of Norse settlers into Iceland during this time. During the settlement period, the Book of Settlements describes almost around 3,000 different names of settlers and 4,000 different areas settled in Iceland. It is believed that most settlers in Iceland, just like Ingolfur, came from Western Norway. However, genetical and some historical records support a large number of Celtic settlers most likely brought to Iceland as slaves or wives by the Norse. Now, asking and explaining why there was this sudden surge of Norse settlement in Iceland is like asking why there was a sudden emergence of Viking activity across Europe. Even though there isn't any one definitive answer to this, most historians accredit theories of social upheaval, changing trade routes, and consolidation of power in Scandinavia. But there is a general agreement that by the end of the 10th century, the influx of settlers in Iceland died down. How many people exactly lived on the island at this point is still debated, and the number can be anywhere from 10 to 50,000 people. With many people now settled in Iceland, disputes and feuds started to become more common amongst the settlers. To solve these problems, people decided to turn to an age-old Germanic and later on Norse tradition called the Thing. The Thing was an assembly made up of free people from the community led by the most noble chieftains named Godi. The Thing was supposed to settle disputes, mete out punishments, agree on boundaries, set up price levels, etc. Naturally, with no centralization on the island, multiple things were created by various chieftains around Iceland. However, by the year 930 or so, Thorstein Ingolfsson and other chieftains in southwestern Iceland decided to create an Althingi, an all-encompassing thing for the whole island. Althingi, just as any other thing, did not have any army or police under its power to enforce the decisions made, and therefore, if the chieftains wanted to enforce the decisions of the Althingi, they had to do it on an individual level. Also, it is notable that many of the disputes didn't even make it to the Althingi, as many prominent chieftains tried to settle disputes between their men on their own, or at the very least, the men themselves settled the disputes between each other. During the 10th and 11th century, we know of the exploration and settlement of Greenland, and also the founding and temporary settlement of Vinland, today's Canada. We mostly know this thanks to the two Icelandic sagas, the Saga of Greenlanders and the Saga of Eirikur the Red, which talks about Thorvinur Thordarson and his wife Gudridr, which gave birth to their son while in Vinland. Icelanders hail this as the first European to be born in America came from Icelandic descent, but there is lots of dispute about this, as the settlers from Vinland came from Greenland, which in turn came from Iceland, which in turn came from Norway. Nonetheless, the sagas aren't a very trustworthy source anyways, especially when it comes to particular details, but it is believed that their overall story is in fact true. Back in Iceland during this time, outside of its Althingi, Iceland wasn't a very unified country. There was no kings, no earls, no chieftains with direct vassal power as you would see in mainland Europe. Also, compared to much of Europe at this point, which was largely Christianized, Iceland was very much happily adhering to their pagan Norse gods outside of maybe few small numbers of Christians. However, when Olafur Tryggvason, an eager Christian convert, became the king of Norway, he set out to convert much of the Norse world, including Iceland. Converting Iceland was a very hard task, and there wasn't much progress made until 999, when Olafur, fed up with Iceland's resistance, sent two converted chieftains to the Althingi, proclaiming he would no longer tolerate defiance, also while keeping locked up several sons of the Icelandic chieftains. After a long debate, the Althingi decided that the main religion of the island will be Christianity, but pagans were allowed to worship in secret. Here, the written records seem to support the archaeological finds, which state that pagan burials stopped somewhere around the early or middle 11th century. With the Catholic Church now established in Iceland, it was quick to gain large power in the Icelandic society. Power of the church could be demonstrated through many of the churches that grew up all around the island. The churches were also the centers of learning in Iceland, and priests were oftentimes the only educated people on the island, and most books were kept in the church's possession. The heightening power of the church on the island versus the power of the chieftains created many disputes over the upcoming years. When I started this channel, I released a video about the history of Reykjavik/Iceland. Now, I was learning lots of new stuff back then about YouTube and about how to make these historical videos, and that unfortunately led me to make several mistakes in the video. Many of you pointed out these mistakes, but sadly the video is still one of the most popular videos on my channel. So to make up for misinforming a lot of people, I made hopefully a much better and comprehensive video about the history of Iceland.